There are so many great players in the NHL, and there are many who get the credit they deserve, but there are also many who fly under the radar. I discussed my top 10 overrated players in the last video, which you should go check out after you finish this video. Anyways, these are my top 10 underrated players in the NHL. Remember, the players on this list were placed here because I think they're underrated, so if I miss someone, make sure to let me know in the comment section below. Let's get started. Mattias Ekholm is really underrated in Nashville. In last year's playoffs, he was a big contributing factor to making it as far as they did in the playoffs. He finished the 2016-17 season with 3 goals and 20 assists for a combined 23 points. This is not bad for a defenseman playing on the second pair, only being paid $1 million a year. In the playoffs, him and Roman Josi, Ryan Ellis, and PK Subban were the heart and soul of the Preds squad, and they pretty much carried their team. We've seen Nashville make improvements to their offense by adding Nick Bonino and acquiring Kyle Turris in a trade, so if the young Predators continue to grow, there is no doubt they could become a future dynasty, like the Chicago Blackhawks were. As long as they can keep stealing contracts like Mattias Ekholm's, they might be the real deal, all thanks to underrated players like Mattias Ekholm. Matt Calvert plays a depth role in the Columbus Blue Jackets lineup. He was drafted 127th overall in the 2008 draft and has become a permanent part of the Blue Jackets in 2013. Last year, Calvert posted 15 points in 65 games. While these aren't numbers that wow anyone, Calvert was for the majority on the fourth line. This season though, Matt Calvert has scored 4 goals and 11 assists in 24 games so far, and he's on pace for 32 points, an NHL career high. This is all coming from a player at the bottom of the depth chart, being given little amounts of time to work with, and I have to say, he is exceeding expectations. Yanni Gourde went undrafted in 2011, and he lit up the QMJHL that year. He agreed to a 1-year deal with the Syracuse Crunch and quickly became one of their top forwards. Up until last year, Gourde had only scored 9 points in the NHL and was signed to a 2-year, $2 million deal last summer. This season, Gourde has already scored 11 goals and 13 assists for 24 points, and he is playing the role of third-line center. Tampa Bay saw potential when they signed Yanni, and they're smart to have such a great young player signed for only $1 million a year. Yanni Gourde has the potential to become a great star, but he's shrouded behind the skill of Stamkos, Kucherov, Point, and Johnson. But if he continues to grow, he should become one of Tampa's top players. Blake Wheeler was named the captain of the Winnipeg Jets when Andrew Laud was traded away, and he hasn't disappointed. Wheeler has scored more than 60 points in 5 of his 6 seasons with the Winnipeg Jets, and this year, he's leading the Jets in scoring with 9 goals and 32 assists for a combined 41 points in 36 games played. Blake Wheeler is on pace for 93 points this season, which would be a career high for him. Wheeler is being paid $5.6 million per season, which is great for the Jets when you consider that other teams' best players who are scoring a few more points than Wheeler are being paid over $8 million per year. Blake Wheeler is now 31 years old, but I can't see him slowing down for a few more years. In 4 seasons with the Capitals, Evgeny Kuznetsov has scored 53 goals and 129 assists for a combined 182 points. Kuznetsov is just 25, and he signed an 8-year contract worth $7.8 million over the summer. This season, Kuznetsov has scored 38 points playing second-line minutes, which is 10 more points than Backstrom, who has only scored 28 points this season in one less game than Kuznetsov. Evgeny Kuznetsov is on pace for 87 points this season, which would be 28 more points than last season. Kuznetsov is young, which is why he's slotted behind Backstrom, but if he can continue to shine like he has been, we could potentially see Evgeny slide into the number one center spot. Until he overcomes Backstrom though, he will continue to be underrated. Phil Kessel had a rough early part of his career, playing for the struggling Maple Leafs. He was logging first line minutes and scoring many points, but because he was on a team that was struggling, he was often perceived as an overrated player, and while that seemed true, he proved that he was not when he came to Pittsburgh. Kessel has won 2 Stanley Cups with Pittsburgh over the last 2 seasons and has been a big part in both of their championships, especially in the 2016 Cup run where he was on a line with Nick Bonino and Carl Hagelin. This season, Kessel has scored 15 goals and 24 assists for a combined 39 points, which is leading the Penguins in points this season. Kessel is on pace for 86 points, but his point total could dip if the Penguins decide to keep burying him in their forward depth in the third line. The Penguins' top scorer is on their third line, so there's no doubt that Phil Kessel is being underrated by his coaches and by fans, which is why he deserves some recognition by being on this list. Mark Stone of the Ottawa Senators was drafted 178th overall, and he was underrated right from the start of his career. Stone had over 60 points in the 2014-15 season and the 2015-16 season, and over 50 points in 71 games last year. This season, he has been moving up and down from the first line to the second line, and he has scored 31 points in 34 games this season. Stone is leading the Sens in points so far, even beating out Duchene and Carlson, and for a team at the bottom of the league, it's not fabulous, but it is good. Stone is only 25 and is currently making $3.5 million a year, and will be a restricted free agent this upcoming summer. Ottawa might not be able to re-sign Stone, and that would be a shame for the Senators, but it could be great for other teams like Vegas, New Jersey, or Columbus, who seem to want to win now and have cap space. In 70-plus games in his last two seasons, Vincent Trocheck has put up an impressive 53 and 54 points. Trocheck is only 24, and he's already on the Panthers' second line. In 36 games played so far this season, Trocheck has posted 35 points, which is almost a point per game pace. If Trocheck can keep this elite level of play up, he could definitely make headlines around the league and could lead his team to a playoff berth. Trocheck is being paid $4,750,000 per year, and for being the Panthers' leading point producer, that's not a bad deal for Florida. Now, Florida could build around Trocheck and other young stars like Barkov and Ekblad. They could be serious contenders for many years to come. In the midst of the avalanche of a team, Tyson Barrie has been a good point. Although there were rumored disputes between Barrie and Patrick Waugh, they seem to have cleared up, or at least diminished, and the 26-year-old has been producing impressive offensive numbers. In almost two full seasons over the course of 2014 to 2016, Tyson Barrie averaged about 51 points. Last year, he scored 38 points in 74 games, which is alright considering his team was absolutely awful and he was one of their top point producers. This season, in 34 games played, Tyson has 4 goals and 23 assists for a combined 27 points. He's third for points by a defenseman and he's on pace for about 64 points. He did just break his hand though, so his chances of reaching a career high of 64 points could be shattered. This would be a shame since he is such a great young player, but because he's only 26, he should be able to make a full recovery. One of the most underrated players in the NHL has to be Anders Lee. You might know Lee as being John Tavares and Josh Bailey's line mate, but he's much more than that. In almost three full seasons, Lee has scored 145 points, 85 of those being goals, and in 36 games played this season, Anders has 22 goals and 15 assists for a combined 37 points. Lee is among the top 3 scorers in the league and is on pace for 50 goals. This is all coming from a player being paid $3,750,000 per year. Lee is also locked up for next season, so if the Islanders can keep Tavares, who is only being paid $5,500,000 this year, maybe they could be a force to be reckoned with. Were you surprised by some of my choices? Did I forget to include a player on this list? Be sure to tell me your thoughts in the comment section so I can hear what you guys are thinking. Make sure to give this video a like if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if you're just finding out about me. Make sure to follow me on Instagram and Twitter to stay updated on the channel. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you next time.